hey, brothers and sisters, I need to make a quick video. I'm serious. This is the thing. Yes, I am serious. Here's the video. There's some brothers and sisters who are trying to get nominate me to be on Sid Roth, brothers and sisters. And there's a process. You have to submit stuff. So what I'm asking, I'm going to put the email of this sister below. Paloma is her name, Sister Paloma. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. And you can email her. And what I'm asking you to do, and she can even, if you have any questions or comments, you want to contact Sid Roth Ministry yourself. You can do it on Facebook and then by his email. You can look this up. And brothers and sisters, the thing is that, you know, I wrote a book, but it's not really about supernatural stuff. We're going to send him a copy of the book that the Lord gave me to write. And then, because I think it's needed in the body of Christ. That's why the Lord gave it to me, because it's needed in the body of Christ. And number two, you know, I did those words. If I gave you a word of wisdom, a word of knowledge that, you know it was from the Lord, or the, you know, healing oil and all that different stuff, anything that you know, and then there's some people of you, like Sister Tonto, she, as an example, she's watched all my videos since I first started, and I've discussed the things that the Lord used me for before, over the last 14 years I've been in the ministry, signs and wonders and miracles that I've seen. I can't even remember them, brothers and sisters, all, unless I sit down and start telling about it. There was a sister I talked to on the phone the other day from Ohio, and we started talking. She was asking me questions, and I just started telling the stories of the things, you know, my testimony and all the visions and dreams that I've had, and the healings I've seen, and words that I've given people that came true over years, like the orphanage. I talked to the house mom and house dad 2007 and told them that they would get married and be the house parents for an orphanage. That was in 2007, and then it wasn't until September 2012 that it came to pass, as an example. And I'd even moved to a totally different city. We were 3 hours apart during all that time after the first year I was in the Philippines, and all these things, you know, tons of things. And I'd ask you to email her, and then if you want to email me, I'm neartochrist@aol.com. I'll put that below here. And then her email, I'm going to put that below here. And you could just submit it to me and remind me of those things. I guess I could make a testimony video too that we could, you know, send to Sid Roth or whatever. But they want a submission, like they don't want to open attachments, you know. So you have to send, I'm going to send them a hard copy of the book. Send them this, like, if you send a testimony, and then the sister is going to, Paloma, she will print them out and then submit them in a packet, because they don't want to open attachments because they said of viruses or whatever. So I asked you guys to help me out do this. I appreciate that, because I, you know, many of you tell me, and I believe it's true by the grace of God, you know, that's the blessing of the internet. You know, someone can get on here, and then, you know, if you have, you know, you don't have to go through the man's system and control of, you know, pleasing these, and that's what's wrong with these churches. They got people pleasers, and, you know, you got to say what they want you to say to get out there. But through the internet and things like that, boom, you can get out there directly without going through the permission of man. You know, so praise God for that. And, you know, but there's a downside to that, too. There's some wacky people on YouTube also. But anyway, brothers and sisters, praise God. Praise God for his blessings. Praise God through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Thank you, brothers and sisters, for your help. By the grace of God, hallelujah, that the message that the Lord has given me of repentance and revival, that's what I want to get on there about, talk about repentance and revival. But, you know, the focus of, like, Sid Roth's show is talking about signs and wonders, you know, that it proves that, hey, you're a servant of God. You know, people are excited to hear about those testimonies, and I want that out there. But I want to get the message of repentance and revival to the church, brothers and sisters. So that's my focus, by the grace of God, if I can get on there, you know, to have an explosion of Holy Ghost conviction and power and righteousness. God bless you guys. I love you. Thank you for your help. Praise God through whom all blessings flow. The sun is shining here. It's 45 degrees, but the sun is shining. So praise God for that. Blessed be his name. Hallowed be his name. Thank you, Lord, for the creation. Thank you, Lord, for the sun, the sand, the sea, the snow, the mountains. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Blessed is his name. Hallelujah. He is holy and worthy of all praise. Let's praise him and worship him, brothers and sisters. You know I can't make too short of a video. You know how I am. You know, I got to praise him, you know. You know, when I was a co-founder of a church, and I was the only white person, and everybody else was black. And, you know, they have praise breaks in the, you know, traditional black American church. They have praise breaks. Everybody gets up. You know, the pastor will start doing a Holy Ghost dance, and everybody will start dancing and praising the Lord. You know, so it's nice to have a Holy Ghost dance, brothers and sisters, sometimes when the Spirit of the Lord is in my heart. I will dance like David did. I mentioned that in another video that I haven't loaded yet. I made it yesterday. I need to load it. Anyway, God bless you guys. When the Spirit of the Lord is in my heart, I will dance like David did. That's a song. It's an awesome song. And hallelujah, we need to learn to praise God, through whom all blessing flow. You know, and that the brother of mine, we were prayer partners for 4 years, and he was black and I was white. That's Pastor Billy. Billy Gully is his name. And old Pastor Billy, he would say, you know, because we would go visit all these churches and revivals and stuff, and he would say this, it's true. You know that the traditional black churches, they really know how to praise the Lord better than anybody, but they're lacking in the worship area. And then when you go to a traditional, mostly, you know, white church, like up there, Toronto, Blessing and things like that, you'll see more worship, but not enough praise. And that's really true, brothers and sisters. We agreed on that, that in the traditional black church, they have lots of good praise and not enough worship. And in your traditional white churches, there's not enough praise, but good worship. Brothers and sisters, I pray the Lord. And I want to say this. This is a sign that you entered a good church when there's people of every race in there. When you see lots of different people, that's a sign that, you know, this church is open and free and has liberty and the Spirit is moving. You can have good praise and good worship, brothers and sisters. That's what to look for. There was a sister I was talking to just the other day that I saw a couple weeks ago, and she was telling me that they visited a full gospel, you know, Pentecostal, full God, not the denomination Pentecostal, but a Spirit-filled church. And in there, they saw lots of different people, not just a traditional, you know, they came from a traditional Baptist church where it's like 99%, you know, white, because they're white people. And then they went to this church and there's multicultural people there. That is a sign that God is in the place, brothers and sisters. A sign to you for sure that God is in the place. Because only God can bring these different cultures together. Even though today, young people, you know, these things are changing, you know, as far as old, you know, racism and things like that in America. But, you know, for younger generations. But when you see that, different cultures and races can come together under one banner, that's the banner of love. As the Lord said, as the Lord spoke to through his word in the Song of Solomon, he said, you know, the Lord, you know, the bridegroom took me into his banquet hall and his banner over me was love. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, through whom all blessings flow. Because love is the banner that unites us. We are brothers and sisters in Christ. Don't forget it, brothers and sisters. The blood of Jesus lifts us out of being a male or female, bond or free, Jew or Greek, rich or poor, we're all one in Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God.